Experiencing excessively loud volume during FaceTime calls on your iPhone can be quite jarring and uncomfortable. This issue may arise from settings, adjustments, or software glitches. Don't worry, this guide will provide you with 100% effective solutions to adjust the volume levels and ensure a more comfortable calling experience. Let's get started. Solution 1. Adjust the volume during a call. During a FaceTime call, use the volume up and volume down buttons on the side of your phone. Press the volume down button to decrease the call volume to a comfortable level. Solution 2. Check and adjust audio settings. Open settings on your iPhone, scroll down, and tap on sounds and haptics under ringer and alerts. Use the slider to adjust the volume. This will also impact the FaceTime call volume when it rings. Solution 3. Disable phone noise cancellation. Open settings on your iPhone, scroll down, and tap on accessibility. Scroll down, tap on audio or visual. Turn on mono audio. This might help in balancing the sound output during calls. Solution 4. Restart FaceTime. Restarting the app can help clear any temporary glitches. Swipe up from the bottom of the screen or double-click at the home button to open the app switcher. Swipe up on the FaceTime app to close it. Reopen the FaceTime app and check the volume again during a call. Solution 5. Update iOS. Using an outdated version of iOS may cause software glitches. Open settings on your iPhone, scroll down, and tap on General. Tap on Software Update. If an update is available, tap Download and Install to update your device. Solution 6. Reset all settings. If none of the above solutions work, you may want to reset your settings. Open settings on your iPhone, scroll down and tap on General. Scroll down and select Transfer or Reset. Tap on Reset and select Reset all settings. Note, this will delete your data, but you will need to re-enter Wi-Fi passwords and adjust other settings. By following these steps, you should be able to fix the excessively loud volume during FaceTime calls on your iPhone. If this guide was helpful, don't forget to subscribe for more troubleshooting tips and stay tuned for the next video.